The Gymnastics Association of the Philippines aims to assemble a bigger team for the 2028 Los Angeles Olympics with the hope of repeating or improving the dual gold medal finish of Carlos Yulo in the Paris Games. This story from Andrea Taguines.
A lot of screaming, hugging, and jumping. That's how the Philippine gymnastics team welcomed their teammate Carlos Yulo when he returned home following his historic double victory in Paris.
Gusto kong umiyak, kasi tumataas yung balahibo ko. Nakaka-proud, saka ano po, parang nakaka-excite din dahil kaya niya. So, kayang-kaya din namin.
Yulo was the only Filipino male gymnast who competed in Paris, but the Gymnastics Association of the Philippines plans to change that as it eyes fielding a whole team for the Los Angeles Olympics in 2028.
I'm setting up a team.
Men's team.
Men's team and women's team, for sure.
With Carlos, Eldru.
The lineup will be Carlos, Eldru.
Carrion also plans to recruit Paris bronze medalist Jake Jarman, but only if the Phil British gymnast agrees to switch teams.
Team Yulo 2028.
Yes, ma'am.
Yulo earlier said that he's hoping and praying to have his siblings Eldrew and Eliza compete alongside him in the next Olympics. Although he declined to face the camera, Eldrew told ABS-CBN News that he's also looking forward to joining forces with his brother. Even Kaloy's grandfather, who introduced all three siblings to gymnastics, believes there will be a Team Yulo in 2028.
Sa tingin ko kaya kasi in every competition nakakamedal sila. Diyos ko, para ka ng on top of the world dahil tatlong apo mo nandun doon. Diyos ko, history na naman yun.
This is where Eldrew, the younger brother of Carlos Yulo, trains along with other members of the Philippine gymnastics team. Day in and day out, they show up here in the hopes that they will be able to join Kaloy not only in celebrating his wins, but to compete alongside him in the next Olympic Games to come.
But the athletes assert they will be needing more support, especially in terms of better equipment and facilities to achieve their goal. They say they're even short on chalk, which they use to get a better grip on different gymnastics apparatuses.
Minsan po tinitipid talaga namin. Kung sakaling ano man, maraming chalk, yun. Hindi na kami mangangamba na baka madulas kami, magkamali kami. So, kumbaga, gagawin namin training na lang.
The local gymnastics association is also in need of new coaches.
We have to get another coach to coach, and there's a lot of people who want to coach Carlos now. Not only Carlos, but the whole team.
Meanwhile, Carlos Yulo said he's unsure if he will still be able to work with his former Japanese coach, Munehiro Kugimiya, but he does plan to visit him in November.
I want to say thank you to them for sa help po na binigay po nila sa akin and support.
While other members of the national team continue training, Golden Boy Carlos Yulo will first take a much-deserved vacation. After the break, he joins the rest of his teammates as they prepare for the Southeast Asian Games next year. Meanwhile, the Philippine Olympic Committee admits, after its most successful campaign this year, there is now more pressure to do even better in the 2028 Summer Games.
Competitive Olympics, Tokyo and Paris, number one po tayo sa Southeast Asia. Higher than those who spend a lot, no? Sa mayayamang bansa din sa Asia, from 12 to 10, 10 tayo with Hong Kong. Mm-hmm. The world, from 50 ng Tokyo, 37 po tayo.
The Philippines had its best Olympic showing in the 2024 Paris Games with the medal haul of 2 golds and 2 bronzes. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Here at home, the Philippine Health Department assuring the public there are no new cases of mpox in the country. Health spokesperson Albert Dominguez says the last recorded case of mpox in the Philippines dates back to December 2023. Still, Dominguez says the country's surveillance systems are on alert following the World Health Organization's Global Public Health Emergency Declaration. Singapore reaffirms its support for a peaceful resolution in the West Philippine Sea during the first state visit of Singaporean President Tharman Shanmugaratnam in Manila. Pia Gutierrez reports.
Malacanang on Thursday rolled out the red carpet for Singaporean President Tharman Shanmugaratnam, who is currently in Manila for a 3-day state visit upon the invitation of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Marcos Jr. personally welcomed to the presidential palace Shanmugaratnam, whom he met 2 months earlier in his state visit to Singapore. During their meeting, both leaders reaffirmed the long-standing relationship between Singapore and the Philippines, as they expressed commitment to further strengthen bilateral cooperation, particularly on defense and security, trade and investment, as well as in sustainability and in energy.
The ties that bind us go beyond geography and are based on our strong people-to-people connection. This has given rise to the strong multifaceted relationship which we enjoy today. Singapore continues to be an essential trade and investment partner of the Philippines.
The spirit with which we should embark on the strengthening of the relationship between our two countries. We are on a good track. We've agreed that we should strengthen this relationship, broaden it, and make it a forward-looking relationship.
Both countries also reaffirmed their commitment for peace in the region, as well as for the peaceful resolution of disputes in accordance with international law.
The South China Sea is an extremely important issue and strongly supported the peaceful resolution of disputes in accordance with international law, including the 1982 UN Convention on the Law of the Sea, or UNCLOS. That's fundamental. UNCLOS has to be the legal framework within which all activities in the oceans and seas are carried.
Both presidents meanwhile witnessed the exchange of agreements on the recruitment of Filipino healthcare workers, as well as the MOU on collaboration on carbon credits under Article 6 of the Paris Agreement. Prior to this, both Singapore and Manila have signed a Memorandum of Understanding on Defense Cooperation last July, while MOUs on the fields of health cooperation and maritime security are already in the pipeline.
Hopefully, with this memorandum, we will be able to incentivize both industries and individuals to actively work to reduce their carbon footprint, while allowing the government to mobilize financial resources to boost fiscal space.
The Singaporean leader meanwhile took the opportunity to praise Filipino Olympic champion Carlos Yulo, calling his double gold medal victories during the recently concluded 2024 Paris Olympics a real milestone, not just for Filipinos, but for Southeast Asians as well.
I should say, by the way, that, and you know, these things do matter, there was just something very impressive about the performance of Filipino athletes at the Olympic Games.
Thank you.
Mr. Yulo's 2 goals is the only athlete from Southeast Asia, from an ASEAN nation, who's had 2 Olympic golds ever in any sport. Yeah. So it's a real milestone. Mm. It's a real milestone for all of us. I mean, we shine a bit of the reflected glory of, of the Philippines.
Pia Gutierrez, ABS-CBN News.
Southeast Asia's most aggressive policy tightening comes to an end. The Philippine Central Bank slashed the key borrowing rate by 25 basis points to 6.25%. It's the first rate cut since 2020. It came despite consumer prices in July accelerating to 4.4%. BSP Governor Eli Remolona says that decision came on expectations that inflation would settle within the official target range of 2 to 4%. He also hinted at another possible cut within the year. The central bank now projects annual inflation to fall to 3.3% this year. For 2025, inflation outlook is at 2.9%.
With inflation on a target consistent path, the current macroeconomic outlook supports a calibrated shift to a less restrictive monetary policy stance. Nonetheless, monetary authorities remain mindful of lingering upside risks to prices.
The Philippine government urged to report a more realistic food poverty threshold. This after the National Economic and Development Authority claimed Filipinos who spend more than 64 pesos per day for their meals are no longer considered food poor. Various groups assert the amount is too low.
Nakapagtataka, sabi nga natin saan lupalop nila nakuha yung datos. Sa isang pamilya na may 5 membro ay kailangan talaga niya ng 570 to 580 pesos per day para makakain ng 3 beses isang araw.
Kung sabihin natin 64 pesos lang, energy sufficient diet lang po yung makukuha natin doon. Wala masyadong sustansya.
But the Statistics Authority asserts the 64 pesos budget can cover various meals, including eggs and vegetables, among others. On Thursday, the PSA announced the number of poor Filipinos, including those food poor, went down to 15.5% last year, or 17.54 million people, from 19.9 million in 2021.
This methodology has been consistent since 2003. Ang idea dito ay para makita natin ano ba yung progress that we're making as a nation in terms of reducing the number of families and individuals from that threshold.
Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. moves the observance of Ninoy Aquino Day to August 23. Malacanang says the move aims to promote domestic tourism by providing Filipinos with a longer weekend. National Heroes Day will be observed on Monday, August 26. Ninoy Aquino Day commemorates the death anniversary of the late Senator Benigno Aquino Jr. Let's get an update on the weather now from Pag-asa forecaster Alzar Aurelio. Hi, Alzar.
Hello, Catherine. Today, we expect cascaded rain showers and thunderstorms over Batanes and Babuyan Islands due to the weak southwest monsoon. While the rest of the country, we will experience generally good weather, but we expect isolated rain showers, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Today and tomorrow, there's no. We expect no weather disturbances, the LPA or tropical cyclone inside the Philippine area of responsibility. Over the weekend, we expect generally good weather over the whole country, but we expect, aside from isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. That's our weather update from Pag-asa, Alzar Di Aurelio.
Thanks for making time for us this morning, Pag-asa forecaster Alzar Aurelio.